Let's see how to calculate equivalent weight of potassium dichromate. Equivalent weight of potassium dichromate, K2Cr2O7. This is potassium dichromate. It is also an important oxidant that we use in organic chemistry. So in this potassium dichromate, Cr2O7, it is called dichromate ion. It is changed to chromium ion in acidic medium. So here, per molecule, there are two chromiums. That's why there should be two chromiums. First, we have to balance the number of atoms which are undergoing the oxidation number change. That's why it's this side chromium's 2, that side also 2. So here oxidation state of each chromium is plus 6, this side plus 3, because it is a single ion. That's why for a single ion, its charge is its oxidation state. So here total oxidation number 2 into 6, that means plus 12, that side plus 6, plus 12 plus 6, that means add 6 electrons this side. So that means one molecule or there are 6 electrons are involved. That's why equivalent weight of potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7 equals to its molecular weight by n factor 6. So in that way, equivalent weight calculation of an oxidant, its molecular weight by n factor. So this is the second example for oxidant. Now let's see how to find out the equivalent weight of a reductant. Do you know what is reductant? Reductant, a substance in a redox reaction which undergoes oxidation is said to be reductant. You know, equivalent weight of reductant equals to its formula weight by n factor. Here n factor means a reductant undergoes oxidation. Oxidation means loss of electrons. That's why as n factor we take number of electrons lost. So equivalent weight of a reductant equal to formula weight by number of electrons lost. Let us see some examples for reductants. First one, more salt. What is more salt? More salt, its formula is NH4 taken twice SO4, FeSO4, 6H2O. This is the formula of more salt we frequently use in the volumetric analysis. This more salt acts as a reductant. So how to find out its equivalent weight in this using this formula? Equivalent weight of this reductant more salt equals to its formula weight by n factor. What is n factor? Here in its reaction, ammonium ion won't change, sulfate also won't change, this also won't change, only ferrous, in this ferrous changes to ferric. That means there are number of electrons lost only one. That's why formula weight by 1. Second one, let's see the equivalent weight of oxalic acid. Oxalic acid, you know, oxalic acid also acts as a good reductant. Its formula is H2C2O4. H2C2O4, it is the formula of oxalic acid. Here the change is, here C2O4 2 minus, this is oxalate ion. This oxalate ion changes to 2 moles CO2 plus 2 electrons. This is the reaction involved when oxalic acid acts as a reductant. So how many electrons are involved here? 2 electrons. That's why equivalent weight of oxalic acid is equal to its molecular weight or formula weight by 2. Here in the case of more salt, see what is the oxidation change involved. Fe here, Fe 2 plus changes to Fe 3 plus. How many electrons are involved here? 1 electrons. That's why I wrote here formula weight by 1. So more salt and oxalic acid, they are good reductants used in organic chemistry. So in that way, equivalent weight of a substance depends on its nature, whether it is acid, base, salt, oxidant, or reductant. So based on its nature, we write the formula. So once again, what is the equivalent weight formula for an acid?
its molecular weight by basicity. For a base, its molecular weight by acidity. For a salt, its formula weight by number of charges, that means charge of total cations or charge of total anions. Equivalent weight of oxidant, here formula weight by number of electrons gained. For a reductant, its formula weight by number of electrons lost. So in that way, we use these formulae to calculate equivalent weights of different substances. So this is all about normality and its formulae. Now let's see the relation between molarity and normality. Normality is equal to molarity into n factor. This is the formula we use. Normality is equal to molarity into n factor. See an example. If 0.1 molar H2SO4 is given, 0.1 molar H2SO4 is given, what is its normality? How to find out? Here molarity is already given, 0.1. So in place of capital M, we can write 0.1 into. What is n factor in this case? Already I said H2SO4 is an acid. That's why its n factor means basicity. Basicity means number of H plus ions given by an acid. So H2SO4 can give how many H plus ions? 2. That's why its normality is 0.2 normal. I already said that normality is the symbol. Capital N is the symbol for normality and capital N is the unit of normality also. So using this formula, we can find out if molarity is given, we can find out normality. Next term. So about molarity, I had explained. About normality, I had explained already. Now, there is another word, that is formality. Sometimes in place of molarity, we use the word formality denoted by capital F. Its definition and formula are similar to molarity. But when do we use this? You know, for molecular substances, that means H2SO4, NaOH, glucose, urea, you know, these are all molecular substances, contain molecules. That's why molarity is the word used for molecular substances. But formality is used for ions and ionic compounds. See, for example, sulfate ion, SO4 2-, this is called sulfate ion. If a solution contains sulfate ions, how to express this concentration? Here, to express the concentration of sulfate ions, we don't use the word molarity. Here, we use the word formality. Similarly, if NaCl aqueous solution is there, NaCl contains not molecules, it contains ionic pairs. That's why for such type of compounds, that means ionic compounds and ions, we use formality. So formality definition also similar to molarity. What is the definition for molarity? It is the number of moles of a solute per liter of solution, that is molarity. For formality, it is the number of gram formula units present in 1 liter solution. Number of gram formula units present in 1 liter solution is called formality. So formula similar. Like molarity, molarity formula, what did I explain there? Here number of moles of solute I wrote na, here also similar. Here also W2, it is weight of solute into 1000 by here gram formula weight of solute into volume in milliliters. What did I write in molarity? Here in molarity, I wrote here gram molecular weight. But here gram formula weight. Why? I said already, molarity is the word used for molecular substances, but formula weight is used for ions or ionic pairs. So all the remaining are similar as in molarity. So after formality, next term, molality.